beginning.
GG, I forgot to reset the portrait, the flags for the portrait, so that's why the placeholders aren't there. Alright. If you could remind me what the offensive sliders are supposed to be for your preset 3, I'll fix it. Sorry about that. It's your preset 1, frontline, middle, conservative, 4, 7. There you go. Get the other manager into the call. There we go. Get a commentator in here as well in a minute. There we go. Okay. We're going to try this guy again, but if the thing happens again, obviously going to have to kill him and the call and remove him. There you go. Thank you, FGG manager. Here we go. Counter, short, center, flex. There you go. Should be fixed there. Alright, LS. go. Okay, set up LLSIFG. Actually, let me get a color commentator in here. Or trying to get him in here. Are you in here yet?
It's like, I've been here for a little bit.
Okay, sorry. I'm like looking at several paste bins at once. Set 3 wants front line, middle, aggressive, 3-8. There we go.
Yeah, both of these teams are pretty sure they're watching the last game and thinking, nah, that 7-2 can't happen to us, can it?
Well, I would doubt it. It's a bit of a different situation with the other two teams, I think. But who knows, really, honestly. See, this is preset 2, right? Yeah.
Alright. It's like in the way the defensive setup for both teams, it's very similar.
FGG is running a 4-3-3. It's a different kind of 4-3-3, though. And, that's a 3-5-2 rather than a 3-4-3. It's pretty different. Aggressive 7-7.
I mean, both teams like to go in for the counter.
Right, centering. Gigan. Go. Well, who do you think is going to win then? Out of these two teams?
I mean, seeing as that we saw from Fighting Games General last week, it's going to be tough to say. Lovelive did really well last VGL, but I'm hoping to see FGG pick up the upset win.
Well, Lovelive are under new management, and they have experience, at least older experience and older Pezzes. I'm sure this Pez as well. So it'll be interesting to see how this new manager for Lovelive does. And well, we did see FGG play last time, and they did very well in the qualifiers.
I'm pretty sure two of them were due to last minute goals.
Yeah, there was a FGG 77 who kind of went ham in 90 plus and got a goal for them to put them ahead, I think.
Yeah, Burning Kermit.
All right. You cannot send set mentality per preset in this Pez, but I can start you on plus one depending on what preset you want. Start with preset 3, so I'll start you on plus one then. But keep that in mind if you want to go to preset 2. It'll cost a timeout to go to 0 neutral mentality. Oh, that was the losing effort. That's right. The Burning Kermit goal.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. All right. Subs. All right. Did you put it in your paste bin? Nope. Do you want ability or manual? Love Live Manager. Subs by ability. All right. There you go.
You know, I never really understood weeb games.
What do you mean? More specifically, I suppose. Because there's a lot of different kinds of weeb games.
True. Persona, Shin Megami, Love Live, for example.
Well, Love Live and the Shin Megami Tensei series are a little different. What about them don't you understand?
Pretty much everything about them. I mean, I haven't really been to the generals to read up on them, and I only know about Persona due to Arena.
Oh, yeah.
Which I consider one of the best 2D fighters, honestly.
Well, that's technically a weeb game. So.
Yeah, so was BlazBlue.
I mean, a lot of fighting games are kind of weeb. You got your, like, BlazBlue is pretty far.
Yeah, BlazBlue is very weeb.
Alright, anything else from you two managers? Also, Love Live Manager, do you have a ball preference? Meanwhile, Meanwhile, set it to the Love Live Stadium. There we go, Akiba Dome. Alright, FGG is good. Oh, alright. Sub bird for Keenan. Okay, where are you, bird? There you are. For Keenan. And make her a CMF instead of an AMF. Is that possible? I forget if that's possible on first day.
Should be.
Yeah, it should be, because it's not moving the player. Yeah.
It's just changing their destination.
Yeah. I believe that's fine. If not, then it's rigged, I guess, in your favor. Congratulations. There you go. All right. So do you have a ball preference? Love Live Manager? None. Do you have a ball preference, FTG Manager? Pizza. Alright. No, 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 don't do that. Alright. There we go. Haruka-san. The fuck with lovely visas. Alright, let me get the music.
Yeah, considering this is the Sakura Bowl.
Love Live and FGG. There we go. Alright. That should be good. So let's get started with our second match of the day. Love Live School Idol Festival General versus Fighting Games General. Daily reminder, it's just dive grass.
It's only a game.
Take it easy.
Why you have to be mad?
Take it easy. Oh boy. You're not gonna want to hear this, but I'm already getting the issue again.
Oh my god.
Yeah, I'm gonna have to kick you. I'm sorry, man. I don't know what the issue is.
No, it's actually turning out well for me, though.
Yeah, so. Anyway, I'll play anthems and kick you out, etc. Hopefully the frame rate gets better.
I feel it all around me. I've been waiting for this moment all my life. It's my destiny.
Aqua, shoot!
Alright, here we go, and yeah, the guy had to be removed. Well, rip it. Alright, well, I'll try to find a replacement. Someone else did possibly want this, so I'm gonna try and get him while the game hopefully doesn't do too much here. I'm looking at everything. There's a foul, they're gonna take it quick. Here's Love Live. We'll be getting it over to Nantan. Me trying to block it out. Honkers into a defender for a corner. Yeah, alright. Get this man in here. There we go. Here's a corner. And he didn't pick up, even though he said sure. Alright. Crossing it in. Stinky boat! No. Can't get the hit on it. It's Honkers. Got a little confused. But it's 1-0 for Love Live. right, there we go. Love Live early start with a nice corner header meme goal.
Yeah, it's the best kind of goal.
Here's a cross to Daigo, headered. Datenshi, excuse me, is able to grab it.
Yeah, only a really skilled keeper can catch the header like that, and you can see we've already got a bit of an imbalance in who's got the good keeper.
I'll be out for a throw-in. Fat son of a bitch is the linesman.
He's got a lot of anime he's got to watch on the pitch today. He's very into this match.
It's out, and let's see the replay, see who got the foot on that. I think that'll be a goal kick. Yeah,
now, I missed which preset these teams are starting on, but we've got a lot of different potential playstyles in their different configurations. It should be exciting.
I believe FGG are starting on their preset 3. Oh, shit, I ripped it. You're supposed to be on plus 1 this entire time, Lovelift.
Oh, it's all rigged! But remember, it's just time
out press. Because I was supposed to do that at the beginning.
Yeah, but this is clearly a case of rigging abuse.
Goofy Goober's wide.
Because as soon as you turn their plus one on, the other team gets a great shot off.
So, I don't know if I'd call that great. It was pretty wide. He did have a lot of space, though.
Tell that to that GK. I'm sure the GK is sitting there like, hey, don't let those get off, you know? Tighten the fucking defense up. But yeah, both teams really being allowed to pass wherever they want, pretty much. We haven't seen a lot of defense from either side yet.
Love Liv doing this slow build-up along the wing. Getting it up to Honkers, back heels it over to Alpaca. Trying to get over to its joke, but it's intercepted and stolen away.
Toppest sniff gets a good sniff of that defender as he kicks the ball away.
And there's a foul.
Oh, Nozomi saying, you can't give me a card on my birthday, it's my birthday.
Happy birthday, have a card. The snip puts it over to Daigo, and it's very wide.
Wait, is Nico a cornerback? Cornerback, what fucking sport is this?
yeah, you know, a left back.
The one where you stand back there and be really short, even though you're a fucking defender.
Yeah. She's named Nico Chi, I think, now? Yeah, Nico Chi.
Nico Chi. So cute. So short.
She doesn't have her horn either anymore, apparently.
There have been many changes. Many changes.
Yeah.
Well, in the old version of the team, everyone got a horn, even if they were all, like, you know, they were all DMFs and shit.
Trust me, I remember.
Sincere apologies.
Yeah. We've slowed down a little bit, trying to get it up to Kusoge, but the defense is able to head it away nice and easy. Oh, giving it up right to Stinky Boat. Where did Daigo? Oh, they lose it. Back to Love.
Yeah, the DMFs, or the midfielders at least, are managing to hold. They're not letting the last pass through. Oh!
Foul. No card still. Love, they're getting nice and violent as expected of Alpaca.
Well, it's what they see that, that idle master ball, and they just go into a blind rage.
Oof! That could have been bad. The goalkeeper was tied up there for a minute.
That is a gamble. I know we meme on defensive goalkeepers, but when you see the offensive GK come sprinting out to try to make that catch, and you're not sure if they get there in time, that is scary as hell.
That is the risk with offensive goalkeepers. Personally, I feel like the risk is worth it, but yeah. When it doesn't work out in your favor, Daigo can't get that ball.
FGG have, like, looked incredible on the last 3 or 4 possessions. They've gotten the ball in a really dangerous spot. If you're Love Live, you need to do something differently.
Well, for now, Love Liver sitting all right at 1-0. Getting it over to Honkers, takes the shot right into fundamentals. And it's cleared.
Yeah, she wants her brace, and it was a good shot, but keeper was not caught sleeping that time.
And our Kappa gets the ball, giving it over to Goofy Goober. Just loses it to Nontan.
Yeah, it's really individual play by the midfielders on Love Live that are making it possible, because you get past Nontan there and it's a really easy shot.
Here's FGG trying to get it over to Kusoge, does pick up the ball, controls it, popping it in. No, it's headed away by the defense and cleared.
Now, maybe if FGG had a little more support for their striker there, you'd be able to play that one on the ground and not have to risk the kind of wild cross to the header.
Sneaky Boat isn't able to beat the defense. It seems to be the name of the game is crosses to the middle from about the second third of the pitch, I suppose.
It's true. Everyone knows that crossing is the new meta.
Yep.
Friendship ended with through balls, now crossing is my best friend.
Yeah, here we go, Alpaca. Nobody's able to get that. Fantastic.
Honk, honk. Was that a very, very wild header, or did I think an FGG defender deflected the header from Honkers. Yes. Oh, no. Yeah.
No, it was just nobody got it at all.
Oh, well, yeah. What do I know? Well, it's a team full of 14-year-old girls. They're only kind of hitting puberty. They're not taller than, like, 5 feet yet. I don't, you know.
Goofy Goober crossing it over to Kusoge, isn't able to control it.
I continue to admire Nico, the fullback.
Nico Nui. It's 1-0 for Lovliv at the end of the first half, though.
But not for lack of trying an FGG's part.
Yeah, not too bad. 3-1 to 4-3. Alright, Lovliv are going to go back to plus zero at the half, and they want subs at 65. You got it.
You can see the advantage in the corner kicks, really. Love Live shots have managed to bounce into convenient spots, and fighting game shots haven't quite as much.
Let's see if you're on zero. You are. There you go, Love Live. Right, here's Alpaca. Over to Nico, putting it up to Honk. Honk! Oh! Trying the bicycle kick and lucky to not get a foul for it.
Yeah, but I think lucky on FGG's side for the keeper and the center back had a brief moment of confusion where it wasn't clear who was going to take that ball.
That's a foul against Alpaca by an FGG player, and that's a card. No idea for who.
Alpaca sold it well, but yeah, it was there was no ball there. That was all heel.
Gorilla Mash gets the yellow card. Ooh, nice cheeky little ruse there for their foul kick, but nothing for it. It's cleared away for throwing.
Yes, I'd like to remind the chat that that is the Lady Alpaca.
The lady one white, though?
No, the lady one's a brown one.
Oh, so the male one's the white one, then.
Correct.
Oh. The more you know.
Oh, this is the second... Wait, did... Oh. Okay, I was about to say, Nontan just blew the exact same header in exactly the same spot, and it went out exactly the same way, but I had switched to the stream.
Oh. Doing a little better now that they're off their plus one. Actually getting a little more shots. They got two, I think, this far. Maybe three.
Yeah, and they're not allowing the same easy play through the midfield for FGG, who may have to change things up if they want to get the ball moving again.
Well, coming on the attack again. Honkers. There's Nontan getting over to Nico. Getting it up to Honkers. Bicycle kick blocked by Fundamentals. Out for a corner.
That's we've seen a few of those bicycle kicks from Honk. I think she's maybe trying a little bit too hard. She's completely just eat shit on both of them.
Here's Nantan taking the corner, taking it along, putting it in, punched away by the keeper. Keenan trying to pick that ball up, but Arcap is able to get it up to Daigo.
Good chance for a counter here. It's 1-on-3. No support yet.
Doesn't really have anybody up front. Here's Stinky Boat, though. Stinky Boat. Stinky Boat loses to Nantan. And they're able to keep possession and clear it.
And I promise I'm not biased, but best idol making an incredible amount of play on both ends of the pitch here.
Nantan putting into Stinky Boat's back, and that should be a corner.
These corners keep happening. One of them is going to go in before too long.
All right, subs and a timeout for FGG at 65. You got it. Blocked out by the defense. Nico will pick that up, putting it back in desperately, only over to top of Sniff to the Stinky Boat.
Nico goes tumbling out off the sideline and demands to know why that wasn't a foul somehow.
I'm not sure that was necessary, really. Trying to get over to Goofy Goober, takes a diving header, blocked by the Love Live keeper.
Scary, scary shot. I think you are Sniffy. I don't know, is that the Sniff player or the Stinky Boat player? You can tell how much I don't understand FGG's
boat.
Memes. I think the back of the shirt says something about Sniff Boat, so I'm like, it could be either.
Subs now for Love Live. You got it. Yeah, that'll work. All right. What would you like, Love Live Manager? And it's 64-47, I think. So do you want your subs now too, FGG? And your timeout? Well, Nico's getting the fuck out of here.
Goodbye, Nico.
Goodbye, Zura. And you are coming out. You got your dog and you got Reen. Haha, Reen boy. Put the dog in. Shiitake. Oh, don't sub you out yet. Alright, that's fair. That's fine. Sub Keenan out for another CMF. So Rice coming out. Meanwhile, FGG want Gorilla Mash out, so Piss coming in. And Tapas Sniff is coming out. For Dubaigo, Ume Haram. And he wants to turn off Swarm the Box. You don't have Swarm the Box on this preset. Were you supposed to? Shit. Oh, you were. It's fucking rigged. Shit. God damn it.
Ladies and gentlemen, we seem to have a small rigging issue.
Just a bit.
Please hold.
It was supposed to have Swarm the Box the entire time. Ooh, lad. God damn it. I remember the attacking ones, but not the defensive one for some reason. Oh, well. And they want to go to plus one. Alright. Anything else, Love Live? Got Nico out, and you got Keenan out. Oh. Make Honkers an SS at 70. Alright. You say so. Wants to go plus one.
I realize there are, like, when you're managing, there are like 14,000 things to worry about, and it's very stressful. But as a PSA, if you are managing, pay attention to the little which ATs are turned on icons at the bottom of the screen. You can hopefully prevent rigging issues.
Yeah. I guess that should have been. Well, I didn't. Whatever. It happened. Things happen.
Rigging happens. Easy for Chenko. You know.
Folks, we're going to have huge rings. Huge. They're going to be huge.
Oh, Rin doesn't get a real face. oh, I'm sorry. That's not Rin. That's kill yourself.
That's kill yourself for not having a real face. It's all rigged. Yes, indeed. That's crossing it in. Nobody said her again. Actually, I think that was a bicycle kick attempt.
I want to say, yeah, it's joke with a, indeed, joke of a bicycle kick attempt.
It's miss. Alright, we're going to pause here real quick and make Honkers into a second striker, apparently. There you go. Anything else, Lovliv, at 70? That's it. Alright. Interesting choice.
Oh, your face when this gives the fighting game offense a chance to come back and win the whole damn thing.
It's interesting because I don't think I've ever really seen something like that before. I'm curious to see what it does.
Well, you're probably not drunk enough.
Mirai over to Honkers. Honkers, weak header right to fundamentals. And the last sub will be in a minute for FGG.
See if maybe some fresh legs will give them the extra boost they need to try and get back to a draw at the very least. It's certainly within the realm of possibility. They're only down a goal, and they've had plenty of ease moving the ball. Just hasn't quite converted.
All right. Anana Diaper is going to come off for LOL.
There's a lot of, I mean, again, I don't really hang out in FGG, but there's a lot of, like, piss and diapers and sniffing on this roster. Does this accurately characterize what it's like in your general?
I imagine so, otherwise it wouldn't be on the roster, right?
Jeez, I guess.
And a nice back heel over to Nantan, back to Wooby, getting over to its joke. This is a Dark Kappa.
Yeah, the support was too far away for that play to work. She got pinned down by herself out wide. Good counter attempt here.
Daigo trying to get it up to Kusoge, but again, positioning isn't quite right, and they're unable to receive the pass.
If I were FGG, I would turn down Gegenpress, but I would always turn down Gegenpress.
Kusoge. And over to Daigo, popping it over to Stinky. Ooh. Boat, headed in!
Beautiful, beautiful header.
Sneaks it by the keeper and it's one all. Going to come on, and we're going to have a tiny concession timeout. Lovliv just want to make Honkers back into a CF. And they also want to... Umida is going to come out. PK.
30, your best year. No problem. Yeah, Johanna's wings not quite powerful enough to carry her up to that header, but a really, really well done bit of combination play by FGG to get that attack going. And if it I mean, if I saw this game played out again, I'd think we'd see a lot more of those goals. I feel like, especially in the first half, FGG have moved through the midfield so effectively. I'm surprised they haven't scored more.
And FGG are looking to try again. Slowly building up here. Dubigo getting it over to Goofy Goober. It's staying in. But Loveliver are the ones able to pick the ball up and get it away. Here's It's Joe crossing it in, trying to get it to Alpaca, but headed away by the defense. Almost the end of the game here.
If you're going to step up, now's the time. FGG, Love Live.
4 minutes of stoppage for somebody.
Plenty of time.
For somebody to break this draw open. Liver controlling the ball well. Here's Honkers. Honkers, weak header fundamentals, has no problem grabbing.
Yeah, I know you gotta make those chances happen, but they also have to count this late in the game.
And there's a foul. I don't know about that. That was hardly her fault. Kind of rammed his own ribcage into her head.
Her head's too fat, like the rest of her.
And FGG trying to make something happen. Stinky Poe takes the long shot off the post!
Gabow. And that's it?
That's it. They're not even letting him do the throw-in. That's one all.
Gosh, it's a crushing ending for FGG. They were literal centimeters away from the win. You bounce that very last shot off the post. That's got to hurt. But I think both teams probably feeling like they could have made more happen than they did. Especially Love Live.
Yep. 12-7 to 7-3. So FGG weren't getting that many shots. They were getting shots, but both actually pretty inaccurate. I guess that's kind of a result of both relying on the crosses.
Yeah, 17 crosses, 15 crosses.
Yeah. Two saves and then four saves for the keepers. Your man of the match is Stinky Boat with a 7. Honker's also getting a 7. Fundamental's getting a 6-5. And Datinshi getting a 6. Our match details. At 6 minutes, Honker's from It's Joke. At 50 minutes, Gorilla Mash got a yellow. 65, 2 subs for each team. At 83 minutes, Stinky Boat from Daigo Umehara. The last sub for FGG at 83, and also for Love Live. And that's it.
Never got the Dubigo to Daigo combination play going on.
Here's your attacking areas. Here's your ball winning areas. And your individual match records real quick. Seven shots for Honkers.
Historically, it's been a very Alpaca-focused team. We may see maybe a different style of play with someone else stepping up in this VGL.
Seems so, with Honkers up front as a CF. All right, that's going to do it for this match. I guess we're going to get the draw sign. So that'll do it for this match. We're going to move on to Group B, which will be RSG versus Hanny. Nobody else called this match. Would you like to stick around for it?
Sure. God, if there's one thing I love, it's Hanny games.
Hell yeah. I'm looking forward to it. All right. Let's get this draw theme going.